Saloon Talk, ladies and opinions.
Okay, so Salon had just defined what a detuba is. You give, but chick's not giving any cookie. Jonah, now you understand.
I think it sounded better in Luganda.
Okay. No more.
Ye natakuwa. Natakuwa.
I like how we added that ko at the end.
I agree with what Salon was saying. I think, hey. No, it's the truth. I think with every guy, especially the older guys, when they're running after like the younger girls, obviously he's going to give you money. You want to go shopping, you want to go do your hair and stuff like that. He'll have to give you the dime, yes. But at the end of it all, he's going to come and fetch. Let me use even slang. He's going to come and fetch. Now, when he comes and you're not going to give him, where was he giving you his money? That's the way they interpret it anyway. I've never been the truth, so I wouldn't know.
You don't know you've been deterred.
You've never been deterred?
I've never been deterred.
Okay, let me ask the question.
He's always received what he wanted at the end.
So you have a girlfriend, right?
Yes, I do.
So what do you provide? What do you give her?
Well, one, she's not in the country, so but when she is around, I try to provide what I can, but she's still living with her parents though, so.
What do you provide when she's
around? What would you mean? What would you provide?
What do you spend on? Why do you spend on her? What in particular do you spend on when
what
it comes
would be
to her?
I think to start off with, obviously I'm not living with her, so it's a bit different. So when you get to hang out, it's basically you're going out for what? You're going out on dates, going for movies, going for.
You pay or do you go Dutch or you pay?
Of course I pay. I've been brought up. My dad is a perfect gentleman.
The guys who go Dutch, man, split the bill. In our makeup.
Doesn't count at all. It's never happened for me. But I tell you what, one thing you realize, especially if you go outside Uganda, you'll notice that Ugandan guys are very different. Most Ugandan guys take care of
the country.
I mean, if you're outside
Uganda. Outside countries.
We're all seas. But Jonah is here talking, yeah? But I don't think you do.
Really?
No.
You think I'd actually...
Listen. Have you ever gone to South Africa to visit your girlfriend?
To visit my girlfriend?
Yes. Have you ever gotten out of your pocket, picked money for an air ticket to go and visit and surprise and say, hi, baby, how are you doing?
First of all, my girlfriend is in the States, so that's ridiculously too high for me.
Come on, it's just $2,000.
$160
for a visa.
That's it.
But depending on what your priorities are and at what specific time.
So if she gave you money for for the ticket, would you mind?
Exactly.
If my girlfriend gave me money for the ticket, no, I wouldn't mind. Why would I mind?
You would go. Yeah.
This is a detutha. He's detuthing the chick.
But then if she's the one
told
who
me,
asked,
listen,
you have
I'm
a man in the
come. Yeah, but I believe in equality in all relationships. I mean,
so you believe in going Dutch, assisting,
No. If it's going out on dates, movies and stuff, I can never ask a lady. Even if I was single and I was going out on a date, I wouldn't expect to split any bill. I've never done that now.
Even if you're not dating the chick and
you're dating in a relationship, it doesn't matter if you're married or not, but you're in a serious relationship. It doesn't matter if my girlfriend, in my case, my fiance almost said, listen, I want to pay for dinner today. I'm not going to say no. It's like my dad and my mom living at home and they go out for dinner. Yeah. And my mom says, I'm going to pay for the dinner today. Why would my dad say no?
I've met guys who say no.
In a relationship?
Yeah.
Insecure.
He's not insecure. He just says no. Save that money. Save it for something else. Aww. Why? Why should you pay for the dinner? I can afford it.
He tells you,
Gendo Kolembi, but still for the hair, he'll give you.
Yeah.
Hey. Malaika is dating. Are these men that you're dating, are they Ugandan?
Are they?
Are they Ugandan?
I tell you what I noticed about the two of you. I think you're the girls who would be like, I'm paying for dinner today. And the guy goes, no, babe, come on, I can pay, I make the money. Inside, you're like, yes, I needed a dime. So you're just pretending that you're willing.
Yes, don't assume. Ask, because we are right here.
Now I'm asking, okay, that's a question.
Okay, what's the question?
Are you that kind of girl?
To be honest, if we've been dating for a long time, I wouldn't mind going Dutch. But most of the times, the guy wants to pay. Yeah, Malaika?
Honestly, yeah, you're saying at the inside, no. Mm-mm. I'm going to respect a man as a man. And that's one thing my mother taught me. Malaika, know your place in a home. Omusaja ye musaja, you are the woman. So when my husband or my boyfriend or my man tells me I'm going to pay, I'm not going to start shouting and engineering him. No.
What we're talking about?
I like how Malaika has that omusaja ye musaja. She has financialized it. It's all about finances, not anything else. Omusaja ye musaja.
Here's a simple question. What happens in a case where the lady or the woman in the relationship actually earns more than what the guy gets?
Again, still, like I've said, the man in the house is the man in the house. Doesn't matter if you make it more money or more. It doesn't matter.
If it's that situation, I think I will only foot it if he asks.
Exactly. Don't emasculate men.
No, but I'm saying Judithiana's initial
question. We're being very, very pragmatic, right?
Your initial question was, if my girlfriend offered to actually pay for the meal or whatever, would I be cool with it? And I said, yeah, perfectly, why not? If she asks, listen.
Just on girlfriend level though. Today, yeah? Are you fiancé? Is she a fiancé?
Yeah, almost there.
You're proposing?
Soon and very soon.
Okay, that's boring talk. Boring talk. Okay, fine. Now listen. How about the girls who take the money and don't give? What's wrong with that? What if I don't want to give but I want the money?
I respect such girls, by the way. I do.
I honestly, this is my argument, and I've had this for a while.
Yeah.
I feel like Ugandan girls are the most honest girls that we have in this world, and I think more girls need to pick up and lift from them. A Ugandan girl will never pretend that you're in her league. If you're not, she will show you, she will tell you, she will not waste your time. And then these guys all complain, but these girls, if you have a car, so if you're asking me for my car, where's your car? Listen, yeah, I've told you, if you don't have, I'm driving a Mercedes. That's how a Ugandan, not all Ugandan girls, forgive me for generalizing. And if a girl tells you what her standard is, and you're not it, see, you walk away. Why are you, stressing yourself? Or you work harder.
Era sisobola kugendako gwe manyi tutajja kunjagala era nina okunoonya yoyo kubaka tingoni era wembamutandise bantawanidde
bwereeti ne malaika omusobola kale tuyinza okutwalako wali e Nairobi. So I want to understand this thing. I've had so many girls say that I can take a guy's money. Mm. Is that right English?
You continue. We'll try and understand what you're trying to say.
I can take any man's money without giving him money. Without giving him cookie.
The girls will give you having spent a dime.
If you're saying
you
the
go
guy,
around calling him loose.
If you're saying the guy is wrong to actually give money and expect to get laid in return, why would you be eating his money and you're not expecting?
Because he's a generous man.
Because maybe I do not like him. First of all, the problem with men is everything is you throw money around. You know, like there's money. And one thing a Ugandan girl learned is treat a relationship where a man gives you a lot of money, they treat it very meticulously. As in, they're very, very careful of every detail of that relationship because she knows what she's getting.
So who are you faulting? The guy who's giving her money or the chick who's actually...
I fault the guys. The problem is with the guys. Some guys are kwanya sente, you know?
That, thank you. If you don't want me to like you for your money...
I have apartments in here. I didn't ask you.
Listen, I'm not that kind of guy, first of all. I've never believed in getting a girl using money.
It's not that you can afford it.
Even if I did afford it, and...
Hey, oh!
What?
I got a home from Spain, Gambia, and everything, but...
Kati, how do I know? Okay, so the guys that give money, how do we know that this one wants... for just Bwangu, this one wants for staying. How do we?
I think it depends for someone kind of guy. Yeah. Older guys obviously are not looking for something to stay. By old, I mean.
Are you sure?
No. By old, I mean old. I'm defining old between 40 to 50. Most of those guys are either married and they're just looking for a quick one. Honestly, they're looking for a side thing outside the wife.
Okay.
And home.
Okay.
Then younger guys depends on the age again. If you're looking at probably a 20-year-old, obviously at that age they're probably kids and trying to have fun. So he's just trying to get laid. It's that simple. And then you get to the age where you get into 30, between 30 and 40, probably that's a guy who's looking to settle down.
Okay.
So it depends. If a guy is looking to settle down...
Now let me contradict you.
A stereotype, right?
Yeah, I feel like, no, it's a person. It's in their nature. But I don't care how old you are, yeah? If you're the kind of person who uses money to get people or things done in your life, it doesn't matter how old you are, you'll always be that kind of person. If you're the kind of person where money is not an issue, tell me that, okay, now yes, finally you have a girlfriend, but before you did, any female that came to your home you slept with?
No.
Every single female that came to your home.
My dad is watching this.
Exactly. Because you were in college at some point. Every single female, you never at any one point had a platonic friendship.
I think the way for me it works, if I'm going to ask a girl to come over to my place, I want something. I'm not calling you to come and play cards with me. Well, you're coming for business. There's no playing cards. We're coming here to do, we're in business here, you know? And then, honestly, if a chick, that's the way I look at it anyway. If a girl accepts to actually come to a guy's place, she knows what, there's a chance something is going to happen.
No.
That's the way a good number of guys will actually tell you that.
No.
You see, I feel like there's nothing like detoothing, man. We're trying to break down what detoothing is. If I come to your home for you to get the cookie, you pay for the cab. You know, you'll also buy the clothes. If we're going out, you know, it's not detoothing. However, please, 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 please get part of the topic by going to our Facebook page. It's UrbanTV.UG. Twitter handle at Judithiana. Jonah and Malaika are still here. Spectra Salon and Spa is the number one salon. Don't forget that.
Salon Talk, ladies and opinions.